Welcome to the 2018 Middle School High School Choir Concert. We hope you're in for a great inspirational night. Our kids have worked very hard to prepare some difficult literature this year. I'm very proud of their effort. So we hope that you leave tonight inspired and a little bit wowed. Without further ado, I give you the 2018 Lessons and Carols.
A reading from the book of Numbers. I see him, but not now. I behold him, but not near. A star shall come out of Jacob. A scepter shall arise out of Israel and batter the brow of Moab and destroy all the sons of tumult.
A reading from Isaiah, the 9th chapter. Nevertheless, the gloom will not be upon her who is distressed, as when at first he lightly esteemed the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, and afterward more heavily oppressed her by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan, in Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelled in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end.
A reading from Luke, the 1st chapter. 6 months after Elizabeth knew she was to become a mother, Gabriel was sent from God to Nazareth. Nazareth was a town in the country of Galilee. He went to a woman who had never had a man. Her name was Mary. She was promised in marriage to a man named Joseph. Joseph was of the family of David. The angel came to her and said, "You are honored very much. You are a favored woman. The Lord is with you. You are chosen from among many women." When she saw the angel, she was troubled at his words. She thought about what had been said. The angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have found favor with God. See, you are to become a mother and have a son. You are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great. He will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the place where his early father David sat. He will be the king over the family of Jacob forever, and his nation will have no end. Mary said to the angel, "How will this happen? I have never had a man." The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come on you. The power of the Most High will cover you. The holy child you give birth to will be called the Son of God. See, your cousin Elizabeth, as old as she is going to give birth to a child. She was not able to have children before, but now she is in her sixth month. For God can do all things." Then Mary said, "I am willing to be used of the Lord. Let it happen to me as you have said." Then the angel went away from her.
reading from Luke, the second chapter. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
I would like to invite you now to join us as we sing Silent Night, which is number 80 in the hymnals in front of you. Please join us.
reading from Luke, the second chapter. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning the child.
A reading from Matthew, the second chapter. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed.
Jesus leads the blind to see, the deaf to hear, and the dead to new life. From Mark chapter 8, "Then Jesus came to a place, and they brought a blind man to him, and begged him to touch him. So Jesus took the blind man by the hand and led him out of town. And when Jesus spat on the man's eyes and put his hands on him, he asked him if he saw anything. The man looked up and said, 'I see men like trees walking.' Then Jesus put his hands on the man's eyes again and made him look up, and he was restored and saw everyone clearly." From Mark chapter 7, "They brought to him one who was deaf and who had an impediment in his speech. and they begged Jesus to put his hands on him. And he took him aside, the multitude. And Jesus put his fingers in the man's ears and spat and touched the man's tongue. Then looking up to heaven, he sighed and said to him, "Be opened." Immediately his ears were opened and the impediment in his tongue was loosed, and he spoke plainly. And from Luke chapter 8, while Jesus was speaking, someone came from the house of Jairus, the synagogue leader. "Your daughter is dead," the man told him. "Don't bother the teacher anymore." Hearing this, Jesus said to Jairus, "Don't be afraid, just believe, and she will be healed." They laughed at him, knowing that she was dead. But Jairus took her by the hand and said, "My child, get up." Her spirit returned at once, and she stood up. Then Jesus told them to give her something to eat.
A reading from Matthew, the 6th chapter. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothes. Consider the ravens. They do not sow or reap. They have no storeroom or barn, yet God feeds them. And how much more valuable you are than the birds. Who of you, by worrying, can add a single hour to your life? Since you cannot do this very little thing, why do you worry about the rest? Do not be afraid, for your Father has been pleased to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give to the poor. Provide purses for yourselves that will not wear out, a treasure in heaven that will never fail, where no thief comes and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also."
Should the shadow
Please stand, stretch a little bit, and join us for Joy to the World, number 84.
Reading from Matthew, the 28th chapter. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age."
Thank you.
Thank you. Please have a seat. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. I want to thank all of our readers who are our staff members who more than willingly read for us so the students can focus on singing. I want to thank the students for all their hard work and for singing in front of people, which is one of the scariest things in the world to do, proven fact. I want to thank Mrs. Gloria Petish over there. Can we give her a hand, please? I also want to thank all of our parish volunteers who decorated the church today for Christmas. It just happened to be on the same day as our concert. A little miscommunication there, but we worked it out. But there's still a few things left. So if any of you would be willing to just hang back for 5 minutes and help us just set up a nativity scene and a couple other things, we would really appreciate that help. With that, high school members, stay right where you are. And thank you so much for coming out tonight. Middle school, you are excused. And thank you so much.